In this video, we're doing cell or particle counting using the Neubauer hemacytometer, and we'll calculate the concentration per unit volume. The hemacytometer itself consists of a thickened glass slide, it's relatively heavy, with dual chambers that are mirrored on each side, and with a central counting area consisting of 25 square millimeters, and we'll be looking at that. The loading area where we will put this fluid in there is the little slit that will then go over top of the cover slip. And this cover slip is special. It's a little bit heavier than a regular cover slip, so the surface tension of the water doesn't float it. So you don't use a regular cover slip. The kit also comes with a white blood cell meter. It has a little white blood thing in there, and that provides a 1 to 20 dilution, depending on what you're counting. And then the other chamber is used for red blood cells, and we can see the cute little red shaker in there. And that would be doing a 1 to 200 dilution. And that, of course, all depends on the concentration of your cells or particles that you're counting. I'm going to be doing yeast today, and I'll be doing a hand 1 to 20 dilution using pipettes. So as we do this, we want to make sure that our hemacytometer is cleaned before we start. Generally, you're always going to want to clean that when you're done, and we'll do that when the video is at its end, but it never hurts to check, and I'm using some lens cloth to just wipe it off. I know I cleaned this last time I used it, so I don't have to worry too much, but it never hurts to make sure. And so we did the cover slip, and we want to do the same thing to the mirrored surfaces. Now be sure you always use lint-free lens tissues or a very soft cloth. Never use a hard paper cloth that can tend to scratch the mirrored surface and leave scars on there. So now that we have that cleaned, our cover slip would go right on top. And again, this is a special cover slip, so don't use a regular cover slip that you use for light microscopy. And now let's dilute our samples and then load it. So I have a yeast concentration here that I just made up, a little bit of sugar and yeast. It smells good in the lab. So I'm gonna do 950 microliters of my buffer, and that depends on what you're doing. If you have cells, you would wanna do buffer so you don't lyse them. So I'm just using a phosphate buffer. And so 950 microliters, and putting that in the microfuse tube, because I'm going to want to mix that in the end. And then I'm going to use 50 microliters of my sample, which then gives us a 1 to 20 dilution. And mix that up to make sure that they're all in suspension. And then add that to my buffer, or diluent, whatever it is that you're using. I'm gonna cap that, and I wanna make sure that all of our cells don't get concentrated at the bottom, so I'm just gonna do a little vortex here and get them all mixed up. And now I'm ready to load the hemacytometer. The volume that it takes is approximately 10 microliters, and I'm gonna just put that on there. The cover slip sits 0.1 millimeters above the counting chamber. So when we do our calculations, that's if we count 1 square millimeter and divide that by 0.1, we're going to have to multiply by 10,000 in order to get a concentration for 1 mL. And we'll see that in the final solutions. And so we have that loaded, and now we're going to take a look at it on the light microscope. When we do this, we're going to count 5 different squares, generally speaking: the upper right, the upper left, the lower right, the lower left, and the center. And so as we come across there, we can see then the 25 millimeter squares stop, and then they start again at the very bottom. So again, we're going to where the three lines that limits our area. So now I've gone to a higher magnification to do our actual counting. And when I count, I want to be counting the top and the right-hand side. Any cell that hits those two, I'm going to count. But I want to make sure that I don't do extra counting. So you usually can count the top and the right-hand side, but don't count the bottom and the left-hand side. If you change and do the left and the bottom, that's okay. Just be consistent and pay attention to what you're doing. So now I'm going to go ahead and count the cells and see how many I have in the first full square millimeter. And that turns out to be 46. And so then I'm going to go across and count the right-hand upper square. Again, using just the top and the right as my limits. Anything that hits the left and the bottom, I don't count. And so here I would be counting these that just hit the line, but I wouldn't count those on the left-hand side or the ones there at the bottom. So now I've completed my counting again on the five squares, and I've counted 263 cells. Now, before I get carried away with calculating and finding out my results, I want to be sure to clean up. Do not ever let this dry, because otherwise you're going to have a real problem in your next counting. You're going to have particles left on there, and that you may have trouble determining whether they're your current particles or old ones. So I'm going to rinse that well with DI water and give that a good wash again with my lint-free cloths, lens tissue. You can use cotton lint-free cloths, whatever you do, but don't use a coarse paper. Wood fibers are pretty bad for delicate things. Put that away, and then I'm going to do the same thing to my cell counting chamber. And this is the most important part, because that mirrored surface, you want to just be sure that you get that nice and clean so you don't get scratches and things like that on there. Again, with my lint-free cloth, and I'm not putting much pressure on that. I don't need to do that. I just got done. That's why you want to make sure that you get that cleaned up right away and not let it dry out. Put things away. It always makes it nice so that when you do it next time, you don't have to worry whether it was done correctly or not. So after I put everything away, now I can do my calculations to determine what my results are for the concentration of yeast cells per ml. And that equation shows cells per ml is the total number of cells counted times the dilution factor times 10,000 divided by the number of squares. So I counted 263 yeast cells. 1 to 20 was my dilution factor, times 10,000 divided by 5 gives me 1,052,000 yeasts per ml. Thank you.